Alright, what is up everybody? Probably be one of the first videos I upload to my channel. I've been lockpicking for about 5 months now. I've gained a fair bit of knowledge. Obviously, I still have a lot to go. I would say my level of picking, where my skills would probably be, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say about I'd say I'm half. I'm about 5. When I finally got down to the security pins, that's what jammed me up for a while. Then I figured out, I started picking spools, serrated, then a combination, and then T-pins. I've picked a few locks with drunken spools, which are two T-pins, in the same chamber, like a spool, but broken in half, obviously. I can pick Americans, Avis. I'm trying to think of what else. That's in my mind. I would say I'm about a 5 out of 10. And I view that as the 7 to 10 on my 1 to 10 rating system as the medium high security locks, medium security or like high security, like legit high security, like multi locks and etc. So what this channel is I loved watching other YouTubers. They all do great jobs. The problem is they're all too far advanced. They have older videos out, which are helpful. I watch them over and over again. The best way to learn is to practice. The more different videos you can find, you never know which video may click with you the best. And my thought on this channel is, if I'm newer still, I can teach people who are not at my skill level, and there may be other people around my skill level who are interested in, I'm always interested in seeing people who are picking the same type of locks I am, and maybe how they did it and whatnot. So maybe if there is somebody around my level or above who is interested, and they watch and they're like, hey, you can improve that by doing this, that, etc. So it's just a all around learning and teaching both ways. So because I see a lot of people trying to pick, when they first start picking, they'll start with master locks like this, which is nothing wrong with that, because that's what I started with. And I see people say that they've been struggling with it, and obviously you don't know why they're struggling with it. A quick rundown, when I first started picking, I bought a dollar store lock, and I had one of those credit card sets I bought at a local store. And I bought that dollar store lock, and then I had also bought a Mountain Security brand lock, which is actually right here. The dollar store lock, I had that put away. But this Mountain Security brand from Walmart, it was $2 and some change. Took them both home, and I had them both open. I didn't even know what I was doing. I had no idea how locks work, etc. I just stuck it in there from the 30 seconds I had watched on YouTube and said, all right, I know what I'm doing. Well, I did manage to get the locks open, but then I couldn't do it consistently, and it intrigued me enough that spark, it just instantly took off. So, with that being said, then I finally ordered a junk set off eBay, an $11 that came with a practice lock. And they're not bad to determine if you want to get into the hobby. Because you may not like it, and before you waste all this money, you got to make sure of that. Because I've been in about 5 months, and I probably got about $1,000 worth of locks, picks, accessories. I'll get into that later, but yeah. So, but again, what I was referencing is a lot of people start out with masters, and that's a good starting point. They're easy locks to get into, but it'll teach you the fundamentals of how a lock works. I practice on these every day up until I got into spool pins and whatnot, and I still even pick this up and pick it a few times just to always jog that muscle memory. So I will do a video series on masters and brinks and whatnot, and I know there's videos out there, but like I said, this is from my perspective. And also about this channel, I have no idea if this channel will even take off. I may never have a viewer in my life. That's fine. I put the information out. depending on how this channel grows, if it does, I have a full-time job, but I'd be consistently able to upload or make videos just about every day. I do work 12-hour days, but I come home and after I eat and whatnot, I lockpick. That's what I like to do when I'm not spending time with my fiance. So, well, where was I going with this? I'm trying to keep this raw. Not really into the editing stuff. There's no reason, especially when trying to pick a lock. I want it to be down straight to the point. Be able to understand everything in my perspective. About the channel. Sorry. One of the videos I'm gonna do, not this video, but I may have some different things I could give away, depending. It's not like an incentive to get people to subscribe. I know a lot of YouTubers in general do that, and mine's more just as, you know, there are locks that I have. I ended up getting 5 of the same lock. I only ordered one, and they sent me 5, and they told me to keep the rest. So, a 6-pin with removable cores, and they used the American series, you know, American lock keyway. So, I can't wait to open it up and try and pick it and see what happens and what's in it. But I have 5 of those I can give away, you know, if people were really serious. It's more about learning, you know, for people who don't have locks like that. If you have a lock like that, I don't really want to give it away. I'd rather give it away to somebody who needs it, you know, who could benefit from it, because this community has been very helpful. I've bought a lot of things off of eBay and whatnot, and there's been a lot of helpful sellers that I've stayed in contact with. They've hooked me up with some free stuff. You know, I'm always trying to buy what I can to improve. So with that being said, I'm sure this video is already getting close to being long enough. So I changed my mind. Instead of doing this, I will do this in the next video. This is a lower challenge lock, pinned up with security pins. But like I said, I do see a lot of people start with these masters. So to top this video off, it was basically about an explanation of the channel, what to expect. And we'll start with this master that I see a lot of people on Reddit in particular. You know, they always starting out have master locks, which obviously is understandable. It's one of the most common locks I see anywhere. I actually have a hard time finding different types of locks without going to a locksmith and whatnot. And now I'm trying to find the keys. Hold on, I got keys everywhere. I can't tell which one's which. So I'm just gonna show you what the bidding looks like. It's 4-pin. Make sure you can see behind that. Yeah. No, nothing terrible. You got your low, medium, low. So the lock works great. It's like a perfect locker lock, you know, nothing valuable, just, you know, you just don't want anybody in your shit. I wouldn't trust your valuables in it. It works great, it's lightweight, and it's cheap. Other than that, I'm sure you can shim it. I don't own any shims. I want to get some. It's just one thing I always forget to get, the butterfly shims, because there aren't ball bearings. You know, and you can cut this if you really wanted to with bolt cutters. Nothing special, just hardened steel. It's not boron. So, without further ado, put this in the vise. I'll zoom in and we'll pick it. And I'm not sure if a lot of you know how a lock works. So I'll give the quick rundown. What happens is when you put your key in, it raises all the pins above something called a shear line. And actually, I don't know if I can bring the laptop close enough, but so this is what's happening in your lock. The pick's going through. You know what? Actually, let me restart this GIF. And we're gonna play it from the beginning. Okay, so before I play it, I'll explain this, how a lock works, and then I'll pick this, because this lock will only take about 30 seconds. So, this darker brown, I would say like brass color, that's your core. You got the red pins or your key pins. that is where the bidding of the key would line up with. And when the key's in there, it lifts all these key pins, the red pins, up to this green line, which is your shear line. And the red pins will all lay flush with that shear line. And it'll therefore lift your blue pins, which are your driver pins, above the shear line, creating a very, very tiny gap between the pins, allowing this core to turn. That's basically how the lock works. When you use your tension wrench, that's what this is here in the video, and you apply tension, it turns the core a little bit, and because of the imperfections in machining locks, it causes one of X amount of pins to bind. For example, this lock is a 5-pin lock, so one of those 5 pins will bind when you take your tension wrench and put a little bit of tension on the lock. And what you do is you take your pick and you go in. You can start in the front or the back, and we'll play, and I'll explain along with this now. So your tension wrench goes in and you apply tension. One of those 5 pins is binding and you have to find it. You lift up. If it feels springy, if it feels springy, then it's not binding. In this example, the third one, it went above the shear line, and you'll know when you get there. It's like a speed bump, they call it. When you have tension on your core and you run your pick through there, one of those pins, you know, it'll move freely across all the other ones because they're springy, but one of them, you'll hit like a stop pretty much. It'll almost tell you, like, hey, I'm the binding pin. Or you go in one at a time and lift up, and whichever one is the hardest to lift up, it has the most resistance, that's your binding pin. That will be your first pin that needs to get pushed above the shear line. And then you just repeat the same process. And now again, this is for standard pins. The blue pins are driver pins. You can overset them, meaning it goes too far up and all that, but as you see, he's going through. And obviously, once you get one binding pin, then you get another binding pin, and another, and finally when you get the last one, all the driver pins will be above the shear line, all the red pins will be flush with it, and it allows the core to turn. We'll get into spool pins later. I have a few gifts of those. So that is essentially how a pin tumbler lock works. There's not a lot to it when they're basic like this. And now some locks you'll see will work, you'll get real easy, and you know they have standard pins. Other ones, like Sargent, they make such higher tolerances. Not perfect, because we're still able to pick it, but high enough to where it's tricky to pick. But Master Lock, for example, they use junkier cores, and that is what allows us to be able to pick them up a lot easier. They're not machined as well. Okay, so to prevent this video from being a half hour long, hopefully it's not too long for any of you. I don't want to edit it. There's nothing I need to edit out, I don't think. If I stutter, I stutter. That's how people are in real life. We'll get into different type of wrenches in a video. There's plenty of videos out there, but I'm going to use, I'm not going to use, this is top of the keyway tension wrench, but for my masters, most of them I use the bottom of the keyway, which this one I use a lot when I use bottom of the keyway, and I've actually made it myself, and I'll show you how to do that. It took me about 30 seconds with some windshield wiper parts. Every time I would hear about that, I would be like, that ain't gonna work. And one day I had some old ones and I said, let me try it, and two of them were different sizes. So this thicker one works better sometimes for me, but other times I need to use this one. I made it the same, it's just a little bit skinnier with wires. Anyway, to top off this video, this master lock has 4 pins, very simple. So I'm going to put my tension wrench in, and I'm going to apply just light tension. Tension is a big thing you need to learn. When you're dealing with spool pins, security pins, lighter tension is typically the way to go. Sometimes not, but I'd say 90% of the time in my experience, yes, like feather, like barely touching the tension wrench. I'm trying to have it so you can see. So, for the in general, I guess, not for the masters, but you can put as much tension as you want on, but it's going to make that binding pin that much harder to lift up, and that therefore can cause broken and or bent picks. And the picks I'm using are Peterson picks, and I don't want to break them. I've already broken a few. So you can start with light tension, and if nothing's binding, then you can go ahead and add a little more, because the less tension you have to put on it and get a binding pin, the better, because then it's less force, upward force, that you have to push that pin up. And hopefully you'll be able to hear the clicks. So I'm going to zoom in just a hair. I don't want to block your view. Four pins, I like to start in the back, check everyone, work my way to the front, and just repeat. So here we go. I'm going to use, like, not heavy, not light, just a little under, between light and medium. And I'm going to use a regular hook one from Peterson, short hook also is what it's known as. And we'll get into different types of picking. This is single pin picking. That's what I prefer. I mean, I do this as a hobby, as a challenge, as a puzzle. We'll get into rakes and all that. That's more for like a quick entry and, you know, getting quicker false sets. And I'm not about speed. I just like doing it for fun. But I do want to become a locksmith one day. I will obviously go over all that to keep this video from being any longer. Let's pick. Start in the back of the lock. Hopefully you can hear this click. Okay, there was my first binding pin. Okay, so I already have the lock pick. I only heard two pins. The other two must... Sometimes they can already be at the shear line where they need to be. Other times you barely touch it while you're trying to get another pin and you set it. It just works like that. So that's all there is to, not all there is to, but that's the start. Zoom out, not in. So alright, I hope you guys like this. I hope I'm informative enough and not bore you to death. I've seen some YouTubers, you know, they're kind of just, this is how they'll talk. They'll be like, this is an American lock, and let's pin it up, and let's put it, and they're all blocking, mumbling, talking real quiet, like I just was. And then you have other great YouTubers, I don't need to say their name, you should know who I'm talking about. They're pretty popular, and I love watching them, but, you know, I want to help inform, and possibly be able to learn myself from other people in the comments. So, I will make another video of a challenge lock, and I'll do a variety of both. Lower end locks, security locks, and everything in between, and about a lot of different stuff. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Leave me comments, thoughts, suggestions, whatever, hate, like, you know, I don't care. I want to hear, you know, what you guys think, and hopefully this helped to anybody, and if it did, let me know. If you have questions and you think I can help, please feel free, let me know. Let me know down in the comments. Alright, thank you guys. And if you like it and you want to continue your learning, hit the like button and subscribe. If not, that's fine. It's not for you. Alright. And remember, frustration and lack of sleep are one of the two biggest reasons a lock will not open, in my opinion. And I've read that about a few other people. Set it down. You know, it takes practice. A lot of practice and a lot of patience, and then sometimes it starts falling in place, and then you have days where you can't get something that you opened a million times. Practice and patience. Alright guys, until next time.